بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا كريم. This is our second lesson going through the book العوامل المئة authored by عبد القاهر الجرجاني. In the previous lesson we spoke about the introduction of the author خطبة الكتاب. We mentioned that the عوامل the author will discuss is 100. We define what عامل is. And we mentioned that we can divide it up into two categories. تنقسم إلى قسمين لفظية معنوية. We define them both. لفظية بمعنى you can see it actually in writing. معنوية it's abstract. Right? محمد رسول الله. محمد here. It's مرفوع. What made it مرفوع? How do you know it's مرفوع? الابتداء. This concept of ابتداء is abstract. فاللفظية منها تنقسم إلى قسمين. We can divide the لفظية into further two categories. سماعية and قياسية. سماعية بمعنى it is known by the Arabs. Through we know it from the Arabs through hearing, meaning there's no qa'ida, there's no principle that combines together these words. All right, حروف الجر, these are حروف, that's it. You can't add anything to it. There's no qa'ida that combines them all together so that you can then make qiyas from it, as opposed to qiyasiya, where there is a qa'ida, a generic principle, and anything that meets that principle falls under this عامل, or work as an عامل. He then says that the sama'i is the majority, 91 عاملا, 91 out of 100. والأنداء السماعية والقياسية منها سبعة عوامل 7 out of the 100 fall under القياسية والمعنوية نوعان. So 91 plus 7 is 98, 98 plus 2 is 100. فالجملة 100 عامل. So it begins now with العوامل السماعية. قال المصنف والسماعية منها تتنوع على 13 نوعا. We can divide the سماعية into 13 types. So the سماعية we said overall is 91 types. This 91 amount, these 91 عامل can be categorized into 13 categories. والسماعية منها. So these 91 عوامل, we can divide them into 13 groups. تتنوع على 13 نوعا. النوع الأول حروف تجر الاسم الواحدة فقط. So the first type is حروف. So they are حروف. And what do? They make one اسم مجرور. So they force one اسم to take the case of the genitive case or the جر case. وهي 17 حرفا. And the author mentioned 17 حروف. 17 حروف. Some raise it to 20, but 17, these are the famous ones. The first one is الباء. The first one is الباء. أحدها الباء من حروف الجر ولها معاني. ولها معاني. أحدها, so the first one out of the 17 حروف is the باء. And the باء is of course من حروف الجر. And it has many different meanings. So it has many meanings. The author mentioned some of them. منها الأول للإلصاق. لصق, right, which is to paste or to attach. نحو مررت بزيد. I went by زيد. In the sense, أي التصق مروري بموضع يقرب منه زيد. My passing was attached to or connected to a position which is close to where زيد was. And that's the main meaning of باء. And of course, this is where the خلاف comes in the ayah, the fiqh خلاف. In قول الله تعالى, وامسحوا برؤوسكم. When you wipe the head, your hand will connect to the head, will attach onto the head. Now this ilsaq, is it a complete ilsaq, meaning there is no tab'id, or is it a partial ilsaq? So this is where the khilaf comes into play. The Shafi'iyya, what do they say? They say that ba' is al-tab'id. So it's ilsaq ma'a al-tab'id. So you come with what adana al-mash, yujzi'. So if you wipe any part of the head with your hand, then you've come with the command of wamsahu bi ru'usikum. Whereas the Hanabila will say la, rather the ilsaq here is bidun tab'id. Therefore you have to wipe the entirety of the head to come with this pillar. طيب, good. الأول للإلصاق نحو مررت بزيد أي التصق مروري بموضع يقرب منه زيد والثاني للاستعانة. A second meaning of that is الاستعانة. And this occurs when the حرف الجر is at, or the ba here is attaching onto آلة الفعل. So if you have a فعل and you have the tool that you use to perform said فعل and you have a ba which enters upon this tool, then you are showing that you used this tool to do said action. You used this tool as an aid to do said action. كتبت بالقلم. I wrote with the pen. Meaning I used the pen. أي استعنت في الكتابة بالقلم. In the process of writing, I used as an aid the pen. Right? نعم. So this باء, when it attaches onto القلم. القلم is of course أداة الفعل. It is the tool that was used to perform the act of writing. So when this باء enters upon that tool that was used to perform the فعل, we say the باء here is للاستعانة. The باء here is للاستعانة. والثالث للمصاحبة. The third meaning that the back can take is للمصاحبة. نحو خرج زيد بعشيرته. بعشيرته، أي خرج زيد بصحبة عشيرته. So when I say Zayd went with his people, or يعني what we mean by this is Zayd went in the company of his people, بعشيرته, with the company of his people. والثالث للمصاحبة، للمصاحبة. والثالث للمصاحبة. And generally, نعم. So والثالث للمصاحبة نحو خرج زيد بعشيرته، أي خرج زيد بصحبة عشيرته. Zayd went out with the company or in the company of his people. Okay, good. والرابع للمقابلة، والرابع للمقابلة نحو بعت هذا بهذا، أي قابلت هذا بهذا. So the back can also be used as an element of when you are transacting certain items or when you are trading an item for an item, right? I brought this for this. So the back here بمعنى for, right? للمقابلة to compare two things together or to bring two things in front of each other. أي قابلت هذا بهذا. I juxtapose this with this. طيب, good. So that's the another meaning that the ba can potentially take. والخامس للتعلية. You can also use the ba for the purpose of تعلية. Sometimes you have a فعل لازم which you want to attach onto the مفعول. مثلا ذهب. ذهب is a فعل لازم. Right? Because it's a فعل that is connected to the فاعل. Right? It is صفة. It's a فعل which is قائم بالفاعل. ذهب عمرو. ذهب محمد. The one who did the act of going is محمد. Right? نعم. And so if you want to connect this فعل to the مفعول, you need to come with in this case, ba, right? ذهبت بزيد. I أذهبته. I you want to say that this فعل of ذهب, I did it to زيد. I did this فعل of ذهب to زيد. I want to make it transitive to زيد. And so there are a number of ways to do this. You can use the همزة مثلا, right? أذهبته. But you can also use the ba والجر. When you use the ba والشوط التعدية, right? ذهبت بزيد. أي أذهبته. I took زيد with me. You want to show that this فعل of ذهب happened to زيد, right? So you say ذهبت بزيد. And so you bring this back to show that the فعل can be what made متعدي, to make the فعل متعدي which was initially a فعل لازم. والخامس للتعدية نحو ذهبت بزيد أي أذهبته. والسادس للظرفية, sometimes the back can come بمعنى في, مثلا نحو جلست بالمسجد أي في المسجد. I sat in the mosque, use the back here, but you want the meaning of الظرفية, meaning I sat inside of the masjid. والسابع زائدة, the seven, the meaning is zaidah. And of course, some of the ulama mention silah, because in the Quran it's not nice to use the term zaidah, and some shubuhat might come out from that because of people who are ignorant of the Arabic language. When we say zaidah, what's intended here is the harf has a meaning. However, you can still come with the speech without this ba. And so in the Quran, you say harfu silah, طيب, but you can also use the term zaidah as well. نحو هل زيد بقائمين, بقائم. You can just say هل زيد قائم. You can say that. And generally speaking, when you bring this back is to show what أي معنى بلاغية, which we'll discuss in علم البلاغة. ومحل الشاهد here is نحو هل زيد بقائم أي هل زيد قائم. Right? So the meaning is هل زيد قائم. But you come with the back here to show further emphasis. هل زيد بقائم. Likewise, مثلا وكقوله تعالى وكفى بالله شهيدا. أي كفى الله شهيدا. You can just say كفى الله شهيدا. And generally the كفى you can bring to يعني when you want to make the fa'il of kafa, when you want to bring the fa'il of kafa, you can do it with the ba'ul jar. So you can say وكفى بالله شهيدا. طيب, good. أي كفى الله شهيدا. You can say كفى الله شهيدا, but the ba' here is حرف صلة, right? أي the حرف has a meaning, it has a job, it has a function. However, you can come with that speech or it's possible to come with the speech. يمكن, it is possible to come with the speech without this ba'ul jar, which is why from this essence it's considered زائدة, but it does have a meaning. طيب, good. And generally the meaning is the معنى بلاغية. So that's the seventh meaning that it can take potentially. والثامن للتفدية نحو بأبي وأمي. May my mother and father be in ransom for you. Right? So the ba here is للتفدية, to show that you are ransoming or sacrificing your parents for like مثلا how the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم sacrificed his parents for سعد بن أبي وقاص. إرمي يا سعد فداك أبي وأمي. Right? نعم بأبي أنت وأمي يا رسول الله فداك أبي وأمي. Right? إيه نعم. That's what meant by. So when you say بأبي وأمي, the معنى that the ba shows here is فداك أبي وأمي. Right? والثامن للتفدية نحو بأبي وأمي أي فداك أبي وأمي. طيب, good. And then he says in the Hamish للباء معاني أخرى, معاني أخرى, that the ba has many other meanings as well. So he just mentioned some of the most important ones or the most common ones that you may come across. طيب, الله تعالى أعلم. وأصطفي بإذن الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.